So I've taken 150 micrograms of LSD, and it's starting to take effect. I'm feeling it. And we're gonna go to the Hunterian, I don't know how you say it. I only found out about this yesterday, the Hunterian Museum in London. I think there are like lots of brains and genitals and body parts in jars. So I think that should be pretty raw. That should be pretty pretty cool. And then we're gonna go to the IMAX, which is by the Science Museum and the Natural History Museum. And I think we're gonna check out a film maybe at the IMAX and just have a little browse around the theaters and museums and whatnot. Yeah, just see where the day takes us. So actually getting into the Hunterian Museum should have been quite straightforward, but of course on LSD, everything's a little bit more complicated. Actually putting my bag into the locker took me about 5 or 10 minutes to understand how to work the passcode combinations. And then for some reason I felt really judged by the attendant who was kind of looking me up and down, and he was quite sort of posh looking and he just kind of stared into my soul. But apart from that, we winged it, we got on with it, and we got out as quick as we got in. So surprisingly, looking at dead fetuses and brains in jars actually wasn't that exciting on LSD. So I moved on to the Science Museum, where looking at these crystals and rocks was actually really beautiful and quite fascinating. The cool thing about LSD is when you look at something for a few seconds, it starts to morph and change slightly. The colours become more brighter and vibrant, iridescence just sort of flows from them. So looking at these sorts of crystals and stones was really beautiful and intricate looking. So this was my favourite part of the day so far. Okay, when I came out of the Science Museum, this is where I started to feel extremely confident and exuberant. I'd already felt like I'd overcome the initial rise of the LSD and I'd kind of acclimatized to it. The music I was listening to, which is the music you're listening to now actually, was just really jovial and bouncy, and I was just full of life and vigor and confidence. So walking around in London just felt beautiful. We'll be right back. Seeing some of the skeletal remains of dinosaurs and huge, vast mammals from the past was kind of mind-blowing because I couldn't get my head around the fact that these were not man-made. And also the architecture of the Natural History Museum was just visually stunning as well. The light coming through was just beautiful. Talking of beautiful, then I headed into the IMAX theater, which was a whole different experience in itself. As you can imagine, being on LSD and watching a 3D movie about Earth and astronauts and being up in space was pretty spectacular, I'm not gonna lie. But it was also just beautiful to feel the impact of human beings from a different vantage point, and also not from a negative perspective. It looked at the human experience as quite a positive one overall, communities and people coming together. So that was just a really nice sentiment. So after watching the IMAX movie, I just felt really good about life and about myself in general. I really felt like I'd conquered something today, because I'm normally a very shy person and I haven't really had much experience taking psychedelics out in public before. So for me, it definitely felt like an achievement, and any sort of encounter socially now throughout the rest of the day, whether it was heading back home through busy rush hour, I just kind of enjoyed, and I kind of embraced it.
So let's talk about the day. Firstly, the dose of 150 micrograms was perfect. Any more would have been too much. For example, 200 micrograms up would have been really difficult to process things, to understand what I'm actually doing, paying for things, social interactions, etc. 300 micrograms up, in my opinion, you shouldn't leave the house on that much, unless you're maybe with someone. And I was on my own today, so that was something that I had to bear in mind with the dose as well. Also, the peak kind of lasted around 6 to 8 hours, so even when I got home, I still felt pretty high. And actually, I felt so good. I had so much energy, I had to burn it off. So I actually went to the gym. I had one of the best gym sessions I've ever had in my entire life. I was able to push through pain barriers that I hadn't really pushed through before. I also had so much energy afterwards that I went for a 2.5K run, slightly uphill, all the way back home, and then just listened to my music, and I was just in the most beautiful headspace. Also, one of the main reasons for me taking LSD at the moment is to benefit my own mental health. I've been trying to go sober, apart from the use of psychedelics, so LSD and mushrooms have really been helping me to kind of stay sober, stay in the moment, and work through my cravings.
That kind of did wonders for self-confidence, being able to walk around London just on acid and having to film some of it. And yeah, just even just pay for things and try and do things normally was interesting but fun. Yeah. Fuck, I need to do some more of this shit. This is the life. I feel alive. Today is day three. Today is day three of being sober. And like acid kind of exaggerates all of your feelings anyway, right? So there was loads of moments where I could smell weed, or I wanted a vape, or I kind of didn't like the situation I was in. I felt a bit nervous or apprehensive, but I don't know, kind of just went through the motions, and I kind of feel a bit invincible now, which is pretty sweet. That's fun. Let's do that again. More of that. More of this sober lifestyle, but taking the psychedelics from time to time and just being a bit, I don't know, just letting loose, letting free. Let the weirdness come out a little bit. What the fuck is this cat doing? I swear, every day between about 6 and 7 o'clock, they start to get a little bit mental. Wait a minute. Oh, so am I. So.
What are you doing? You cat!